My name is Peter Kuria. I am currently the president of Kisii University Student Union. I am a third born in our family, and I come from Nakuru, and I share two counties, Nakuru County and Narok County. And I am a student doing analytical chemistry in Kisii University from the School of Human Applied Sciences. I went to a primary school that is also not known, but I was number two in my district by then. It is called Ngondi Primary School. And I went to a secondary school that is called Maela Township Secondary School, where I was the top student by then, and got a grade A minus then. Yeah. The whole of my life I've been a leader. I've been a leader since class four. I was a prefect all along in primary school, and I was the senior school prefect during my high school time. The interest of me, maybe only seeing the presidential seat being the only suitable one for me, was necessarily because I've been following the issues concerning this university and the students, and I was asking about what does this post do, what does this one, and I came to realize that most of the messing ups that we have been having are necessarily caused by the president. And so because I really felt that I was the one sent here by God, that is, I felt it that way, that God sent me here to make things right. That is why I decided that I will go to where those things are messing up so that I can correct them. So I can only correct things from where things are not going well, and that is from the president part. Necessarily, my winning one, it is God who made it for me to win. One, I need to say that I never had anyone sponsoring me. I never had a lot of money. I did normal campaigns from just that level, that Nichini Kabisa, the lowest level ever. But one thing that I had was backup from God. God was really doing this for me. I was peaceful. I had confidence in God taking me through. Because initially, in fact, I had this dream of God making it for me. And so I never had any stress even while campaigning. I just knew that I would win, except that now I had to do my business of asking for votes from people. But it is God who made it. I have always been known as PK, and so it was a trademark for me to give out PKs. It was just to make sure that people knew what PK meant. And in fact, it was a symbol that I would be, like when you look at, I was giving the green PKs as well as the blue ones. So the green PKs, they are obviously sweet, but the green ones, they are a bit bitter in a way. So what that meant is that I was to stand firm in both sides. I will stand for the student family without really pleasing the university, as well as I will stand in the university without necessarily at times pleasing the student because of issues that may bring problems to the students. So it was a symbol that I will be a person who will be there for the students, as well as also for the admin when it calls for that, but for the student necessarily. I had a very peaceful campaign. In fact, people say that it was the most peaceful, and in fact I believe so, that it is the most peaceful campaign that has ever happened in Kisii University. Reason being, one, I was a peaceful person, and I said no alcohol in my campaign, and it was really true. I also never had goons. I only had people from church, friends, close friends, people who are just dedicated in making things right. And so I never had anything to say that we were somehow colliding with any other, like with my opponent, Jeff Muller. We never really collided, except his people. At times they came and made our life not that easy, somewhere at the gate there, by maybe throwing some bottles to us and all that. But I told my people to just keep peace. In fact, that was the statement. Anytime they came to us in a different manner, like they want to bring violence, we told them peace. So there was nowhere that I caused anything to do with like violence or such, because I was a peaceful person, as well as my people understood that. Very few of my families know that I am even a president in the university. Very few, especially my dad. My dad, in fact, he's not a direct dad, but I call him dad. He's the only one whom I can say that he knows, and he asks me every day how are things going. My family just have got a small glimpse of what happened or what is going to happen. So I cannot say that they knew. No, only one person knew. I come from a family that is not, the people who are there, they are not really educated. So they understand less about issues with the university or such. So even trying to explain to them what it meant to be a president in the university is a bit difficult. But I tried to make them understand what I was doing here. I was campaigning. Necessarily, I told them I'm going to campaign. But they never really understood much. But there is one person who knew. In fact, him in my family and then friends, close friends, are not direct family. To me, this business of being a president has never been so big. So it has never been a lie. I just told them, and because I said it in just a cool manner, they also took it cool and positively. But that dad that I was talking about was very happy about it, and he really felt that something good has come to my life. Politics is a dirty game at times, and I can tell you I saw it. I was just saying that is the dirty part, and I just go the other way. And I'm happy because of one. When I was getting into politics, I told my God, if it is you are doing, let it be true. Let it come out clean. And it is truly, it truly came clean. And I cannot say that in any way I felt that I had infringed my side of salvation. I had not. But even after winning, I know that it is still having some issues ahead. And one thing that I am going to make sure that I continuously maintain my salvation is I will ask God for direction. I asked him during the campaign time, which necessarily was the most difficult time and not the best, of course, during campaigns. And he made it right for me. He gave me direction. He gave me ways to follow. He showed me where to do, to follow and what to say. And I believe that he's still going to direct me even in the coming times, the times that I'm maybe going to face some difficulties, issues that may be not very good. I know he'll still give me a way. The most important thing is that God will give me wisdom, and he has been doing it for me, and I know he will do it again. So I'll get that wisdom from him. He will guide me, he will show me the way. That is what I believe. In fact, my presidency is directly just bestowed on God, because I know he's the one who is leading me. My mentor is my dad, that foster dad I was talking about. It's called Charles Kamau Manyara. He's a principal, and he's the one who has been having me since I got to Form 2. He's a great leader. He has done great. He has been severally awarded by the county education officers as the best principal of the year. He's a hard-working guy, and he always looks at how to do things for the people to feel being represented. He likes serving people, and that is why I am here, because mine, as a president, I say that it is about servant leadership, and that is what I liked about him. He really doesn't know at times. I have never told him that you are my mentor. I have never, but inside me, I know that great things and so many other things that I do is because of what I have seen him do. He has done it, and he has done it rightly. Even if I'm a departer at times in fixes, I have seen him doing it. So the relationship is that, one, he has been a great teacher to me. That one is just given. Even if he was my family member in a way, the best part of him is that he has been a great teacher to me, and now a mentor without him knowing. Necessarily, in issues concerning politics at the lower level, I would say that Dad also is also an affiliated politician in a way, but he's really not into it, the active part. But he has a lot of ideas, he has a lot of wisdom in matters concerning politics, and I get some information. In fact, when I'm stuck, sometimes I ask him, what do I do here? And he gives me an analogy, and I get to understand. But in national politics, I have several people that I look as if they are, okay, I look at them and I see them being good leaders. And I never look at tribe, because I'm non-tribal, though I have a tribe, yes, but I'm non-tribal. But I look at some people, key people. One, I know it might look like it is controversial, but I look at Uhuru Kenyatta. He's a person who is very rich, but very down to the level, except that he has many people who makes his name toil. So in that case, I look at Uhuru Kenyatta. He's a good mentor of mine. I also look at Barack Obama. He's a guy who came from nowhere and became what he was. And several others. In fact, this idea of being the president of Kisii University, it originated from far somewhere. And I was telling someone, I used to follow politics even in secondary school. And I used to tell them that I'm the one who's going to change the narrative of the university politics. And I have started doing it, because being a servant of God and coming into politics and winning, which is always not the case, that one is shaping some issues. So to me, and this one is true, and I know with God it is possible, the future presidency of Kenya is here. I am going to be the president of Kenya in future. Necessarily, I will not come out of the president of Kisii University and go to the politics, national politics for the presidency, but I know I'll be getting some step. Like one of the steps, I may be vying for the MP in my area. I am a key person in my area, and I may run for that. But the future, in maybe 20 years to come, I may be in the ballot for the presidency. If all the good people, as they call themselves, the Christians, who are to vie in these positions, and they keep it clean, I will tell you, we'll clean up Kenya. But now the problem is that we have fear, which should not be a factor. Because if you have God and you know you are serving a true God, and you have a true heart of serving people, and God knows that you don't have malicious mind behind it, then he will make you go through it, and you will come out of it clean, and you'll clean up the system that you find yourself in. So it is not an issue of, I am a Christian, so I don't buy. It is not true. It's supposed to be the other way. I'm a Christian, I'm supposed to buy. Whichever thing, I'm supposed to buy. But the main issue about buying is you being there to serve people. Servant leadership is what is needed. It's not about being bossy and all that. It's about servant leadership. Kisii University will not remain in the position it has been. The position of being ridiculed, his name being tarnished. I will stand up for it. And I can tell you, I've started. In a great way, God is going to make an impact in Kisii University. I have a vision of whereby Kisii University will become the best university. Truly, that 21st university century that we talk about will come to pass. Because I am seeing myself in a position whereby I will stand for the university and fight for what it's supposed to be. Number two, I will make sure that students, they feel that they are in a university that they deserve to be. I will bring back hope to them as I promised them during my campaign. Because I want everyone to feel that this is the university they are supposed to be and work towards its betterment. We may not have everything, but I want to make sure that what we have, the little we have, we are going to utilize it. But them that destroy the name of the university, I am going to work on that. And the name of the university will not be tarnished again. Things will be a difference. There will be a difference. But I'm also working towards making sure that what we need, necessarily the simple things like lecture halls and such, are there for the students. So that at least students can feel that they are in the right place. And also the communication that you always have a problem with, that one is also another thing that I want to work for, so that things may go straight. I have a vision of seeing Kisii University being the best university in Kenya, if not in the world. I will start. I may not do everything. I may not bring heaven down here. But my dedication to serving will bring it to pass. One thing that I respect is difference in ideologies. I may be the best, but someone else may see a difference in the ideas. And I'm not willing to victimize or even make people feel that they are not in the university union because of one, they were against me. In fact, today, they can tell you that I don't even care who voted for me or not. They just even don't realize. And some of them are amazed when I greet them, just like any other comrade. They ask, and you knew that I was against you, why are you like this? Because one, I'm not looking to division. I'm looking to unity, because I know without them, the opposition, and without my people that voted for me, I cannot do what I want to do in the university. So to me, all of them are students. That is the common factor, and therefore all of them are important. I don't care who you voted for. That one came to an end when you finished voting. Of course, I'll be there to serve students. That is the name, students, not them that voted for me. So I'm looking forward to a united university, a united students in that union, so that they can also know that it is their union, not a certain person's union. I am willing to work with anyone. I care less about your name. I care just because you are a comrade, full stop.